are here warming up for a day at the movies. It's a big holiday weekend, and that means a lot of big names on the big screen. Courtney Friel here to tell us what's in line. Exactly. I was just going to do the yawn.
Molly, what's up with the movies? Holiday weekends are great for the box office. Ticket sales have been down from last year. And the highest grossing 4th of July opening in history was Spider-Man 2 back in 2004, which made $88 million, followed by the original Transformers in 2007 with $70 million.
Those movies are great.
So Transformers 3, it just had the best opening day of the year. And it's on its way to raking in $200 million by the end of this weekend. Here's what else is new in theaters.
In true July 4th fashion, Shia LaBeouf brings a Save the World blockbuster to theaters, reprising his role in this third installment of Transformers with Dark of the Moon.
With or without you, I'll find her.
As director Michael Bay pins Autobots against Decepticons once again, humans are caught in the middle, and this time mankind is taking sides.
Excuse me, Miss Scott.
As you requested, a 26-pound lobster.
I shall take it in my room.
From intergalactic travels to a European escape. Selena Gomez and Glee's Corey Monteith head to Monte Carlo as a case of mistaken identity turns into an amazing journey.
They give these away for free. Well, they do. I don't.
Tom Hanks reunites on screen with Julia Roberts for the coming-of-age story of Larry Crowne, a middle-aged man who loses his job and goes for a life do-over, returning to college.
Go McQueen!
And with over $123 million in ticket sales worldwide, Cars 2 is revved up to take another lap with its family-friendly adventure.
So mighty. Average intelligence.
Calling those who stay on four wheels and those that take on another form altogether.
There's no way you're going to be able to reach
her. What do you suggest I do?
It's over.
Now let's talk about the reviews. Larry Crowne's aren't so great, kind of mixed, but it is the most sophisticated film of the bunch and has the Oscar-winning cast. For Transformers 3, you've got to bring some aspirin and earplugs because it is over 2.5 hours of banging noises, pulsating, and explosions. But the special effects are amazing, although you don't have to see it in 3D. And Monte Carlo was so fun. I did the press junket the other day and interviewed all the stars. It's a really cute film. And parents, if you have teenage girls at home, they are going to absolutely love this movie. Everyone in the cast is gorgeous. So are the clothes and the scenery. They go to Paris, Monte Carlo.
Yeah, back to Transformers. You know, the Bond movies always have a new girl, and now Transformers has a new girl.
No more Megan Fox. It's Victoria's Secret model, Rosie Huntington-Whiteley. And the reviews on her performance, you can kind of tell it's her first film, but she's gorgeous.
But she's beautiful, right?
Yep.
That's what she's thinking.
And
for.
Did you
she's
hear
the new
scoop?
Transformers girl.
Did you hear the scoop with Shia LaBeouf?
Ooh,
he told Details Magazine that he hooked up with Megan Fox and while they were shooting, and now everyone's wondering was it when she was with Brian Austin Green?
And have a guy?
To which he answered, I don't know, 12 times in a row.
Oh, very, very smart.
They always have to release a little drama to get more buzz for the film.
Hey, it could work. It could work.
Are you going to see any of these movies?
The Transformers flicks are great. You never know. I don't know if I'll have time over July 4th. You know, everybody's grilling and barbecuing, but it's a great rollout time.
Zero Megan
I'm sure
Fox.
Be jumping
in. No Megan Fox in this movie. There's now zero reason to see Transformers.
I cannot think of one.
You don't want to go see it for the Victoria's Secret model that's in
Cars
it?
Cars 2. That's all I'm saying. Thank you, ladies. Appreciate it. I'll be headed to Cars 2 this weekend.